Okay, we're going to go to that right now. Here's a message from President Trump.
I know your pain. I know you're hurt. We had an election that was stolen from us. It was a landslide election, and everyone knows it, especially the other side. But you have to go home now. We have to have peace. We have to have law and order. We have to respect our great people in law and order. We don't want anybody hurt. It's a very tough period of time. There's never been a time like this where such a thing happened, where they could take it away from all of us, from me, from you, from our country. This was a fraudulent election, but we can't play into the hands of these people. We have to have peace. So go home. We love you. You're very special. You've seen what happens. You see the way others are treated that are so bad and so evil. I know how you feel, but go home and go home in peace.
Now, we brought that to you because President Trump on the tape says to his supporters who are right now conducting an armed insurrection on the U.S. Capitol, he tells them to go home. But I also want to note that in that video, he lies about the election being stolen and pours more fuel on the fire. He continues his shameful behavior of lying to his supporters about what happened. It is absolutely disgraceful. I hope they listen to the part in which he said for them to go home. But to be completely frank, there were mixed messages in that video. And I feel ambivalent about the fact that we even aired it, to be honest, although I certainly understand and support the idea that we did. But the idea that the president is not even capable of saying, please go home, he continues to lie to his supporters. And what I wanted to say before, Abby, is I want people to remember how they feel watching these images of the United States Capitol being taken over and these clear acts of sedition and violence and terrorism by Trump supporters, because there's going to be an attempt to whitewash and pretend this didn't happen.
People might attempt to do that, but what we're seeing is pretty clear what is happening. And I think now we have to ask the question, is President Trump capable of leading this country even for the next 13 days? He is inciting violence against the government itself, lawlessness, vandalism, and he's also completely MIA in terms of his principal job, which is to keep this country safe, to protect Americans. Let's not even talk about the fact that we're still in the middle of a pandemic. We haven't talked about that today.
Yesterday, the deadliest day of the pandemic so far.
This is a president who is not paying attention to the job and is focused on just one thing, which is his own sense of grievance. That video was a disgrace. The idea that today, on the day that Congress intends to count the electoral votes for Joe Biden, who will be the next president of the United States, Donald Trump still refuses to say that he lost a democratically held election in the United States of America is a profound shame. And it makes us a mockery in the world. As we go around the world talking about democracy, we have a president who is inciting violence at the Capitol and won't acknowledge that he lost an election.
No, I don't understand how the United States, which regularly objects to elections taking place in other countries,
yeah.
Pakistan, Russia, Hong Kong, I mean, Taiwan, regularly engages in criticism of other countries' elections. What is Senator Hawley or Senator Cruz going to say when Vladimir Putin says, it's interesting that you're faulting us for this because you yourself objected to an election and you yourself helped inspire an armed insurrection on Capitol Hill?
You're exactly right. And the notion of consistency and clarity of message and purpose is unfortunately so far behind us with these issues. And we just have to say over and over again, because what we just heard from the president was so, aside from the fact that he said go home, which was the appropriate thing to say, he said that the election was stolen from us. No, that is what you're seeing on Capitol Hill right now.
Exactly.
What you're seeing on Capitol Hill right now are people, to quote you, Abby, in his name, going to the Capitol, trying to steal the election for Donald Trump, the election that Mitch McConnell stood on the Senate floor just hours beforehand, not even hours, minutes before this happened, and said, this wasn't even close. This wasn't even close. Donald Trump didn't even come close to winning this election. That is the reality. That is the top Republican in the United States Senate saying that, and saying it for a reason. And the Republicans you were talking about, Josh Hawley, I don't know yet about him, but Senator Cruz, I'm already hearing from an aide to him. You know, this is not what he wanted. I think he also tweeted, violence is not the right way to go, so on and so forth, that he was doing his constitutional duty, which might not duty. He's doing what is allowed in the Constitution.
No, Democrats but he wasn't.
Well,
and he was calling for something else.
Right. Well, Democrats in the past, this is almost besides the point because of what's going on here, but Democrats in the past, and you've pointed this out, have objected during this process, but they haven't done it at the behest of a candidate who refuses to concede the election. That has never happened. And that is the big difference here, because that is what these people, these rioters, are responding to. They're responding to the president and his enablers on Capitol Hill.
You know, I think about how we started this day, and I you know, not looking back too far, but just to recall that hours ago, we were talking about the way in which Republicans had fed these conspiracy theories and coddled them for many, many months and even years, living in this imaginary world created by Donald Trump. And they had lost control of that, not knowing that hours later we'd be looking at this incredible scene. But this is the consequence of years of people in Washington refusing to have the courage to stand up and say, right is right and wrong is wrong, and there are facts and there are fictions in the world. And there was a time in this town when the differences between the two parties were about policy, they were about taxation, they were about the role of government. Now the differences between the two parties are about who believes in facts and who doesn't.
Ulysses
that should not be the case, but that is what we are dealing with right now. And I know, because I talk to Republicans all the time who privately will say that they want to get back to that time where they were talking about things that really mattered, but they can't, because they have nurtured this monster and now it is devouring them.
Ulysses S. Grant said in 1861, there are now but two parties, patriots and traitors. And it is time for the Kevin McCarthys and the Josh Hawleys of the world to decide which party they're in. I have my idea about what that might be. Anderson?
Jake, Wolf. Thanks very much. We,
Say in the midst of all of this horrendous news that's going on here in Washington, something that none of us ever expected we would see in the nation's capital. I just want to make it official right now. CNN can now project that the Democrats will be the majority in the U.S. Senate. John Ossoff, the Democratic candidate in Georgia, he is defeating David Perdue, the Republican candidate. Earlier, we projected that the Democrat Raphael Warnock will beat Kelly Loeffler, the Republican candidate. So it's 50-50 in the new U.S. Senate. But the new vice president of the United States, Kamala Harris, she will be, according to the Constitution, the president of the Senate. So she will break the ties. So the Democrats will be in the majority. The Republicans will be in the minority. Anderson, this is important, but let's get back to this explosive situation that's developing here in the nation's capital. As I keep saying, something I never thought I would see.
Yeah, we started out this day saying that it is going to be historic, and it certainly is in a whole bunch of different ways. Obviously, Georgia turning blue is one of them. But we continue to watch the situation where there are still insurrectionists, treasonous people on the grounds of the Capitol, high-fiving each other, as you see there, just wandering around. Police are trying to maintain order, trying to get control back of the building and its grounds. David Axelrod, we heard from President-elect Biden saying, President Trump, stand up, speak out. President did release a video that was, frankly, shameful.
Not exactly what Biden had in mind, I think.
How do you see this day?
Well, you know, first of all, let me say about Biden's remarks. It underscores what we've seen since the election, because basically Donald Trump has resigned the presidency as of his election. He's just been working on this project of persuading people that the election was stolen from him as we've dealt with a pandemic, a cyber attack from Russia, and many other problems.
He's been running a grift while people are dying.
And in each instance, Biden has stood up and played the role that people expect a president to play, and he did it again today and said the things that you would expect a president of the United States to say. As for the president's video, Dana was exactly right. I mean, there was a perfunctory message, which is go home, let's not play into their hands. But as he called these treasonous folks very special, and he repeated the idea that the election was stolen from us, stolen from you, stolen from our country. That is the jet fuel that is propelling this insurrection at the Capitol, this lie. And he just used the video to repeat it again.